If you had all the money in the world, what would you do with it? Would you take a trip around the world? Would you buy a fancy house? Or would you maybe share it with others? Well, the remarkable couple you're about to meet donated $50 million, $50 million, to the Australian National University to help educate young Australians. And we're lucky enough to have them join us now, Graham and Louise Tuckwell. Thank you for joining Studio 10. Gee, this is an extraordinary amount of money, Graham, $50 million. How did this gift come about?
Well, we have been working in business for many, many years, and we were just lucky to be fortunate to things worked out well, where the wealth increased quite quickly. And we sat down and thought, well, we've got to do something about it. And that's what we decided to do.
Well, you were a graduate of the ANU, weren't you, in Canberra? So you credit it with giving you the education that entitled you to make the money you have.
Well, both of us.
Both went there. And many philanthropists don't go public. What has prompted you both to come out and tell your story?
The scholarship program needs publicity. So
because the more people that know about it, the more other people you can influence to do the same with their great wealth, yeah? Yes. Although, if you were my mother, Louise, I would kill you giving away my money, I have to say.
And that's the thing, you have four children. Did you discuss with them that you were going to give away this big chunk of their possible inheritance before you did?
No.
What did they say when you did give it away?
We didn't give them a say. We just said, this is the deal. That's it.
Now, if a graduate, if somebody wanted to be apply for a scholarship, do they have to have a very high score? I mean, how do they get involved?
There's a 95 ATAR floor for the scholarship, but ANU is subscribes to the Educational Access Scheme, by which up to five ATAR points can be added to their score if they are from a remote school or have various life circumstances that mean they deserve an extra boost.
So it's like a Rhodes Scholarship, isn't it? Similar to that?
In a way. Well, it's being termed the Rhodes for undergraduates in Australia, loosely. But not by us, but by other people.
But education, Louise, it must be the way out. I mean, is that what your core belief is?
Totally. It's transforming.
Where does that come from?
Well, Graham and I, both of us, went to very average state schools, large state schools, and fortunately went on to university, were able to, and it was transforming in our lives. And our life trajectory has totally been determined by that university experience. So we'd like to give that opportunity to others.
Gina Reinhardt made the point that if you give too much money to your children, they don't learn the value of working hard. Mm. So when you decided and you told your kids, this is what we're doing, tough, I think you've also been quoted as saying you have to be careful with just how much wealth you share with your children.
Yeah, I mean, if you give too much wealth to them, you're going to destroy their incentive to, you know, fulfilment in terms of their own job, aiming to do things in their own right. In other words, as Warren Buffett says, you want to give your kids enough money to do whatever they can, but not so much money that they don't have to do anything.
Do they still speak to you?
Absolutely. But don't forget, I mean, they don't see any of the applications, but they can see the sort of kids that are coming through the program. So they're looking at it and saying, well, you know, these kids are well deserving of it. They've already had their education, so what more do you need? You know, education, a little bit of a help for a house, a bit of love and you're done.
Well done.
Talk about a $50 million hand up, not a hand out. Guys, thank you very much for coming on the show. We do appreciate it. Now, we're going to head back to David Harris. He's our book critic who is getting stuck into the most eagerly awaited novel in ages, the book that Harper Lee wrote before To Kill a Mockingbird. We will get his verdict on Ghost at a Watchman a little later in the show. And also coming up, all this as well.
It's the tax scam catching out thousands of Aussies.
How much money do you think people pay you?
$87,000 to me.
In a Studio 10 exclusive, the new twist that has shocked the ATO and led to an internal investigation.
I'm not sure how they got that or whether it's a coincidence.
It's quite a coincidence.
Plus, Family Feud, like you've never seen it before. Anything could happen as Grant Denyer joins us live. Studio 10 will be right back. We'll be right back.